Hello, beautiful person. Hope you're doing well. I want to talk to you tonight about holiday stress because even though a lot of people celebrate Christmas, Christmas is over, New Year's is coming, a lot of people are off work spending time with family or spending time without family. Either of those could be a cause of stress. So people just find that this time of year very stressful. So I just went into a little research and I found 10 really awesome tips. I'm only going to tell you three though, because I need to keep it short. But I do have these tips written down in my notes. Hey Linda, hello, written down in my notes. And so if you want those the other 7 tips, just drop me a message and I'll send them to you. So tonight I'm just going to talk about three. So, I'm just going to look down my notes. So, what are my favorite tips for busting holiday stress? The number one stress buster, not just in the holidays, but other times that people just don't do enough of, is exercise. And I'm not talking about killing yourself with a CrossFit exercise, although I personally love doing that. But you could just go around, walk around the block, or if it's too cold, walk on a treadmill, walk in a mall, go walking with a friend, walk around the track, something. Just move your body. Get out of the chair, get off the couch. If your legs are at all functional, go for a walk. Or if you can't, if your legs aren't functional, do some sort of upper body thing. Just move. Get your heart rate up a little bit. Get yourself fit. It will boost your mood. You'll have more endorphins just from moving your body, and it just will make you feel better. Number one, antidepressant, most underutilized antidepressant is exercise, just moving your body. Okay, so that was tip number one in terms of busting holiday stress. Tip number two is also really important, and it's called pick your battles. Okay, if you're spending more time with your family or other people than you normally would, some things may just irritate you, might rub you the wrong way. If you're getting together with siblings that you don't see very much, all sorts of patterns from your childhood might come up. There might be a reason why you don't see each other that much otherwise. All sorts of things. Older siblings may get bossy, younger siblings may get annoying. It's just like all sorts of stuff going on, and you guys are really not in middle school anymore. And you can just pick your battles, and it might be your own children who are driving you bananas because they're home, they're off school, they're bored, they've had too many toys, too much sugar, whatever it is. If there are humans that you are dealing with, pick your battles. Not everything is worthy of becoming World War III. Just, take a deep breath, take a step back. Try and figure out what's going on and just pick your battles. Is this a hill that you're willing to die on? So just a deep breath, a little count to 10, and figure out whether whatever it is just worth the battle. Maybe you can just let it go. Wouldn't that be nice? Okay. And then tip number three is also super important, one of my absolute favorites. If you're feeling down in the dumps, if you're feeling stressed, and especially if you're feeling lonely, go help somebody else. Go volunteer at a homeless shelter. Go serve dinner to street people. Go see, first of all, that your life is not so bad. And secondly, gratitude is just amazing. If you can help other people, your endorphins will just flow, your serotonin, whatever it is that is brought up by being kind to other people. You will just feel better. No matter how much of a pity party you're having for yourself, if you can go and just help somebody else, especially if it's someone who cannot repay you, you are just guaranteed to feel better. So these are my three favorite tips for busting holiday stress. So number one, move your body. Number two, pick your battles. Number three, volunteer, help others. Get out there and stop thinking about yourself. You will feel so much better. So these are the three major tips that I have. I do have 7 others that I've found, which I think are also really awesome, but I don't want to spend any more time talking about this. So If you want more tips, oh, thank you, Linda. I'm glad you enjoyed them. If you want more tips, drop me a message. I will send you the other seven, or I'll just send you all 10. And have a great night. And if you are local to me, I am having an event January 12th at Serratus Movement Center. Drop me a message about that and I'll let you know. So have a great evening. Remember, I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye.